Hello, my name is Harald Brunner and I'm a Product Management Engineer at Vector for the DaVinci Adaptive Tool Suite. In this video, I show you how the Adaptive Tool Suite helps you with modeling tasks on machine and system level. First, I want to show you the elements that are created during this video. A machine design defines the communication aspects of an ECU. For some IP service communication, it needs at least one Ethernet communication connector using a unicast network endpoint. It also needs a some IP service discovery configuration using a multicast network endpoint. An Ethernet cluster is a system design artifact, but also created during this video for testing purposes. Finally, we create a machine with machine states and processor cores. There are also wizards for service deployment, but these are not shown in this video. We start with the machine design wizard in a fresh machine integration project. We use the default settings and click Next. On this page, we have to select the SumIP service discovery network endpoint. As we don't have one yet, we create a new one. We also don't have an Ethernet cluster, so we create a new one and give it a name. Okay, this channel is selected, we click Next. Back to the network endpoint settings, we give it a name and a multicast IP address. The default port number is standardized, but we could change it here. Here we have to specify the network endpoint for the service communication. So we create a new one on the same cluster. It is selected so we can finish the wizard. The new machine design gets opened, but we can also see it in the Model Explorer DML view. Here on top is our test cluster and below the machine design that uses those network endpoints. Now we can create a new machine configuration that references this machine design. Here we leave the defaults and select the machine design that exists already. Here we can select or create a machine state declaration. For demo purposes, we leave the defaults. Below we can select or create function groups to be used in this machine. Okay, we are done here. Let's see what was created in the Model Explorer. So below the machine design, we have the machine state. We have the function group. And finally, we have the machine using the function groups and the machine state. We also have a default processor and OS module instantiation configuration. So in this video, you've seen how the Adaptive Tool Suite can help you to get started with a machine integration. For further information on Adaptive Tool Suite, please see our other videos and visit us on vector.com/DaVinci-Adaptive. Thanks for watching.